Hello friends, in this video we are going to see an interesting topic that the GPU and CPU performance testing using TensorFlow 2.4. So here is the environment I'm going to use it, and you can notice this is the TensorFlow 2.4.1 I'm using, and TensorFlow GPU is more than 2 expression I'm using it. Also, I just show the configurations of my system, and I'm using i7 10th generation, 32 GB of RAM. And a GPU, I'm using this. Almost 8 GB of dedicated GPU is available. And you can notice, this is my CUDA version, 10.02. I'm using on it, the driver is 4.43. So this is the configuration I'm using. Already pre-installed that CUDA and that CUDA DNN library on. Now I'm going to execute and we'll see the performances wise. First, I just start with TensorFlow. You can notice this is GPU and CPU both is enabled, and I'm going to validate and restrict only to run for the GPU or CPU something. So one physical GPU and logical GPU is available. Only we are going to use it for physical GPU. Logical GPU is kind of shared GPU, but we will not use it. And improving the sizes of GPU performances based on some memory growth. And now I'm going to import libraries. And the dataset is almost have 60,000 of data is available. I'm going to take it out. And to train 60,000 of data as well as validation, I'm going to work with 10,000 data sets. We will look up in the upcoming sessions little detail about this, the data values and all. Only we just look it up at performance aspect. So here the number of filter and all I just select, and this is just I created on the ANN network. And CPU, I'm going to run it first. So here you can notice TensorFlow.device, it will be located and will create the CPU. And the batch size, I'm going to use it based on the 2 power of values. So it will restart the batch size 8, and then it will be increased at next epoch with 16, and then something like I'm going to execute via 6, 7 iterations and calculate each of the timing and will be stored into the CPU list. How long for each epoch iteration with the different batch sizes is executed. Yeah, now batch size 8 is just started and ETA just provided. Now we just go and validate. This is just for CPU. You can see it is just take it out 100% utilization right now, and it's executing. So it just takes some time. I just pause my recording and come back. Now first iteration is going to be in. And you can see this is 100% CPU is used. NVIDIA GeForce is not used anywhere. 100% utilization, first epoch is over for batch sizes 8. And then I just increase the batch size into 16 for different environment practice. And same set of data, I'm going to train it again. Now we'll see how long it will take. Now second iteration is going to be in with batch size of 16 with one epoch. So training samples is 60,000 and 10,000 validation. So 169 seconds it was taken with 100% CPU effort and 0 GPU effort. Okay, so dedicated GPU memory is not used, 100% CPU is used. And that accuracy wise, you can validate from 93 will be improved to 97. So third iteration started. Likewise, all the iteration is over. I will show you. I just pause the recording. So sixth iteration is over and last iteration is just started. So all the iteration you can see still. And I can get some accuracy improvements on each iteration. Now it's 99%. Now it's loading for last iteration. So this millisecond it was taken for each iteration, you can see here. Yeah, almost 50% of iteration is over. So that is at 33,000. So within 53 seconds, it's going to be over and we'll see. So each this timing, I just take it out and store into the CPU list in this one. That's it. This is I'm going to append the timing differences. Likewise, the batch number. Batch 8, how long, 16, how long, like that, I just take out the timing also. So still 100% usage and 0% GPU usage. And for better accuracy, we don't do any other optimization techniques. Yeah, successfully it's done. Now I just check all the CPU hours timings. So it must 220 seconds, 227 seconds. It takes for the first batch 8 and 16, this timing. Like that, I just store all the timing here. Now I'm going to enable and run it the same code via GPU. So you can notice this code and this one, both will be same. I'm going to use it. Okay. So just going to run it. So some dropout method and the learning data, I just modified everything, but code will be the same only. Number of filter 32, 512, 0.7, relu, and learning rate is 0.01. You can see. CPU. Okay. Now I'm going to enable via GPU the same iteration code I'm going to execute it. Now let's see how long the time will take. Let me release that memory here. CPU also will be reduced from 100 to 14% right now. I'm going to start it. Now it's start and learn with GPU. 12% just increased because this is very less data, so it is cumulatively increasing the percentage sizes. So it takes only 50 seconds of that. So almost first approach iteration is going to go over in few seconds. Yeah, it is just complete 66 seconds, which means 1 minute. The same CPU, sorry, the same iteration, the epoch operation, I just take it out via CPU around 3 minutes. Second iteration is much faster to compare with previous with batch size as 16. And 12% only it took still. Yeah, over. Back size of 32. It's running. So accuracy wise, we can verify the performances. Batch size 8 has with the GPU 93. Here also the same 93, 43, 93, 38. Second batch size 16, it took almost 97. It is also 97. So similar to same, but the performance wise, the high level competition will be taking GPU. Now GPUs enter into 20% of usage. 25%. It will be support for CPU also. Using CUDA, it is improving that. Okay, almost everything is over. So total 7 iteration also is over, and we are getting 99% of accuracy. So this is the timeline for GPU, and this is for CPU. Now I'm going to map both in the chart, performance chart, and you can see. So GPU is this one. So number of training per epoch will be modified, and batch size will be increased. How long the time will be taken to? So based on that, we can verify the same data set we can see in CPU, the time will be taking more. So the plot point will be the same places, because that number of epochs, the batch size will be the same. The timing only will be varying. Okay, so ratio we can verify. There is a ratio for each epoch interval between the CPU and GPU. So this is the way you can test in your system. You suppose you have a GPU, you just verify. I will share this code in link, you can refer it. Also, please provide any comments or any doubts. We can follow with them and reply back to you. Hope you can understand. Thank you.